그리고 며칠 입력 이루어집니다.
네, 안녕하세요. 저는 전기제어직종 국제지도위원 맡고 있는 유희재라고 합니다. 먼저 여러분과 함께 전기제어직종에 관련해서 방송을 할수 있게 되어서 영광입니다.
Hello, nice to meet you. My name is Hee-jae Yoo. I'm an expert for the electrical installation skills. It's very honored to have this live streaming broadcasting with all of guys.
일단 먼저 채팅에 있는 줌 링크를 활용해서 이제 실시간으로 서로 질문하고 답변할 수 있는 기회가 되었으면 합니다.
I hope this live streaming can be the good opportunity to have a real-time Q&A time through our Zoom link, what you can see on our YouTube chat.
먼저 라이브 방송 진행에 앞서 PPT를 통해서 동영상 목차 소개와 앞으로의 차시별 강의 목차를 한번 살펴보겠습니다.
First, I'm going to give you a brief introduction about our lecturing contents briefly through our PPT files.
네, 먼저 제 이름은 이제 유희재고요. 이제 2019년도 러시아 카잔 대회부터 이제 상하이 대회까지 지금 전기제어 국제지도위원을 맡고 있습니다.
As I already mentioned, my name is Hee-jae Yoo, and I'm in charge of the experts position for electrical installations skills from the Russia, the Kazan competition to the Shanghai competition.
그리고 현재 이제 국내 대회에서는 이제 산업제어 직종의 부심사장을 맡고 있습니다.
And then in Korean skills, I'm also in charge of the deputy experts for the industrial installations skills.
자, 다음으로는 이제 저희가 이제 살펴볼 동영상, 이제 지금 저희가 작년에 한 12차, 13차시 정도로 이제 훈련 컨텐츠 영상을 만들었습니다.
Actually, last year we made the lecturing video clip, which has the 12 to 30, about 12.
그러면 그 목차에 대해서 한번 이제 차시가 어떻게 구성되어 있는지 한번 봐보도록 하겠습니다.
Let's have a look at what kind of video content we have for the lecturing.
자, 먼저 첫 번째로는 이제 안전보호구랑 이제 공구 사용법에 대해서 되어 있습니다.
The first video clip is about the safety management and how to use tools.
자, 두 번째 차시는 이제 파이프 다이어그램 배관도와 이제 덕트 트렁킹 이제 설치를 할수 있는 거에 대한 영상입니다.
The second video clip is about how to draw the piping diagram and processing the trunking.
세 차시는 이제 케이블 트레이의 설치 방법에 대한 영상입니다.
The third video clip is about how to insert the cable tray.
네 번째 차시는 이제 제어함과 이제 박스들을 설치하는 것에 대한 영상입니다.
The next video clip is about the installation of the control panel and box.
자, 5차시는 이제 PVC 전선관의 밴딩과 이제 설치에 관한 영상입니다.
The next video clip is about the installation and the bending of the PVC conduit.
여섯 번째 차시는 알루미늄 전선관과 이제 플렉시블 전선관에 대한 영상입니다.
And the next one is about the aluminum conduit and the flexible conduit.
일곱 번째 차시는 이제 제어함의 안쪽 패널에 대한 이제 배선에 관한 내용입니다.
The next one is about the wiring inside of the control panel.
여덟 번째 차시는 이제 모터 제어에 관한 내용과 이제 PLC의 배선에 관한 영상입니다.
And the next video clip is about motor control part and the PLC wiring.
아홉 번째는 이제 KNX 장비 이제 스위칭과 디밍, 셔터 장비에 대한 배선 내용입니다.
And the next one is about the K and X equipment wiring, such as switching, dimming, and the shutter.
네 번째로는 이제 케이블 포설, 풀링과 이제 연결 방법에 대한 내용입니다.
The next one is about the cable pulling and the connection.
다음 번째로는 이제 시운전 보고서와 이제 펑션 차트에 대한 내용입니다.
The next video clip is about the commissioning report and the function chart.
12차 시와 13차 시는 PLC 프로그래밍 그리고 KNX 프로그래밍 로고 프로그램과 ETS5라는 프로그램을 사용하는 영상입니다.
The last two video clips are about the PLC program by using the logo program, and the other one is about the KNX programming with the ETS5.
자, 먼저 첫 번째 이제 라이브 방송에서 해야 될 내용들은 이제 1에서 4차 시로 이렇게 구성되어 있습니다.
So the first live streaming contents gonna be are going to cover the video clip number 1 through number 4.
자, 먼저 이제 첫 번째 차시에 지금 나와 있는 요 안전 공구와 이제 전기 설치에 관한 공구 사용 방법에 대한 영상을 한번 같이 보면서 이제 설명을 해 보도록 하겠습니다.
So in our first live streaming contents, the first video clip what you are going to watch with us is about the safety management and how to use the tool. So now I'm going to show you the video clip number 1.
I
would like to give you a brief introduction about the whole contents of our video clip.
지금 이제 러닝맵에 보듯이 1에서 13차 시에 관한 영상이 이제 그 촬영이 되어 있고 현재 한국 팀에 대한 유튜브에 이미 등재가 되어 있습니다.
So as you can see from my PPT files saying that learning map, you can see the 13 video clips in total, and you can see it through the Korean YouTube channel.
그리고 지금 라이브 방송이 끝나더라도 이 내용과 이 영상들은 나중에도 유튜브에서 확인할 수 있습니다.
Even if you cannot join this live streaming broadcasting, you can watch or check this video clip and this live streaming broadcastings later.
그러면 먼저 첫 번째 영상 한번 살펴보도록 하겠습니다.
Now let's move to the first video clip.
Competitors will learn safety management and how to use tools for electrical installations. The purpose of this training is to learn how to properly wear protective equipment as per the work process and secure safety with a multimeter when power is on.
기를 통하여 안전을 확보하는 방법을 습득하는 것입니다.
Shall we have a look at materials and preparations? Here we have technical description of electrical installations of word skills, protective equipment and a multimeter. 자, Let us have a look at the key points of this task. First, select proper protective equipment according to the work process of electrical installations. Second, be familiar with how to properly use the multimeter after supplying power. Please double-check preparations in detail and personal protective equipment to be ready for the task. Hand tools may be brought to the competition, but the use of modified or special tools may be restricted. Even if you have the same items as the tools given in the competition, the tools provided in the competition should be used first. depending on the venue of the competition, the manufacturers of the provided electric and other general tools may change. As it is prohibited to use electric and general tools other than the ones provided by the competition, check the infrastructure list before participating in the competition.
지금까지는 이제 선수들이 사용할 수 있는 공구와 이제 지급되는 공구에 대한 영상이 소개되었습니다.
The video contents you just saw so far is about the tools what the competitor can use in the competition.
이제 이 영상들을 살펴본 다음에 이제 1에서 4차시 보고 이제 마지막에 이제 줌을 통해서 이제 이런 내용들에 대해서 한번 의견을 서로 주고받는 게 좋을 것 같습니다.
So after watching the video clip number 1 through number 4 and then I would like to have the discussion time through the Zoom for sharing the information or your opinion about today's first lecture.
1. Let us have a look at the precautions to perform the task in this training. First, wear protective equipment suitable for materials handled during work to prevent injury. When working with steel, wear long-sleeved work clothes to protect the injury of the arm and safety glasses. Gloves should be worn to protect the operator from foreign substances generated during work. Hand cuts may occur when not wearing safety gloves. Eye damage may occur due to foreign substances when not wearing safety glasses. When using a heat gun, bending of conduits, leather gloves should be worn to prevent burns caused by high heat. Working with a heat gun without wearing leather gloves can cause skin burns due to high heat. When using a rotary tool, battery drill, jigsaw, etc., it is essential to wear a dedicated glove to prevent the gloves from getting sucked into the rotating tool. Never use cotton gloves. Second, before using the multimeter, make sure that the target equipment has been energized and wear protective equipment before proceeding. Electric shock accidents may occur when using the multimeter without protective equipment. Accurately learn each function of the multimeter to prevent accidents. Even if the type of tester is different, the units expressing the function are the same. So be well familiar with the units and select the function according to the situation. Check out the description of each function. 1. Check what you are going to perform on this task. 2. For the safety of workers, work clothes should be worn at all times during all operations. Long-sleeved work clothes must be worn as there may be scattering foreign substances during steelwork and material processing. If you don't have long-sleeved work clothes, you can use sleeve protectors. If you don't have long-sleeved work...
네, 지금 내용은 중요할 것 같아서 먼저 말씀드리겠습니다. 지금 작업할 때는 이제 긴팔을 착용하고 작업을 진행하는 게 선수 본인을 보호할 수도 있고 안전 규정에도 맞게 되어 있습니다.
Actually, this is the important point. I would like to highlight this point first, so that all the competitor must wear the long sleeves clothes while working their task to protect themselves. And this is also based on our safety rules as well.
그리고 나중에 직종 정의에서 확인을 해볼 건데 이제. 해당 작업에 관해서 이제 사용해야 되는 작업 보호구에 대한 소개가 있습니다. 그 내용도 한번 이따가 살펴보겠습니다.
Actually, According to, we are going to check the technical description later together, but according to the technical descriptions, it also mentioned the specific safety gear according to each performing task.
Clothes, you can use sleeve protectors. When conduct noise-making work, wear earplugs to protect hearing. If you need to communicate with colleagues and officials during work, remove the earplugs. After communication, put on the earplugs again. Safety shoes should be worn at all times to prevent injuries caused by falling objects. Also, safety shoes should be worn to prevent injury from treading on sharp materials such as screws. Since sharp materials are used for steelwork, work clothes must be worn to prevent cutting accidents. Also, make sure to wear earplugs to protect your hearing, as drills and jigsaw produce loud noises. When wearing non-safety shoes, metal shavings on the floor after material processing can be embedded into the bottom of the foot, so it is necessary to wear safety shoes before starting the work. Use safety gloves to prevent cutting on sharp edges during steel processing.
그리고 이제 회전 공구, 이제 드릴이나 이제 홀소를 사용을 할 때는 지금 장갑을 착용하라고 영상에 돼 있긴 한데 이제 안전상에서 이제 면장갑은 사용을 하면 안 됩니다.
When the competitor use the rotary tools such as the drill or hole saw, the competitor should wear the safety gloves. But it is not allowed to wear the cotton gloves.
그래서 이제 회전 공구에 이제 장갑이 말리지 않는 그런 장갑을 사용하는 게 좋고요. 타이트한 장갑을 사용하는 것을 권장드립니다.
So we recommended that the competitor use the tight and the soaking preventing gloves when the competitor use the rotary tools.
If leather gloves are too thick to use, use working gloves. 작업용 장갑을 사용하도록 합니다. If you do smoothing, deburring, be careful, since the substances attached to the steel can cut your hands easily. Since the heat gun has a high temperature of 500 to 600 degrees Celsius, it may cause serious burns when it touches the body, so wear work clothes to protect it. When using a heat gun, keep wearing gloves for safety. Wear leather gloves before starting the work because the temperature of the heated object is very high and there is a risk of burns if cotton or general work gloves are worn.
자, 이제 요 내용은 작년에 이제 러시아 카잔 대회에서 약간의 이제 해프닝 같은 내용이 있었습니다.
Regarding to this video clip content, so we had a small issue regarding this point in the last competition in Kazan.
이제 PVC 밴딩을 할 때 이제 히트건이 공구로 이제 지급이 되어서 이제 사용을 해야 되는데 이제 뜨거운 작업을 할 때는 이제 가죽 장갑을 착용하게 이제 직종 정의에 명시가 되어 있습니다.
Actually, when the competitor to perform the task such as the bending of the PVC, they need to use the heat gun. So when the competitor handle the hot temperature heating, they need to wear the leather gloves according to our task technical description.
그래서 대회 때 이제 가죽장갑을 지참하지 않은 선수들이 이제 가죽장갑을 구하느라 조금 좀 힘든 상황이 있었는데, 다음 대회에는 이제 무조건 가죽장갑을 함께 가져오는 걸로 이제 하는 게 좋을 것 같습니다.
So actually, in last competition, a few competitor has some trouble in carrying or having their own leather gloves for their competition. So, please make sure to carry and take your own leather gloves for the competition in next competition, please.
을 착용한 후 작업합니다.
Work clothes must be worn when working with a heat gun because it can cause burns if work clothes are not worn.
작업복을 착용해야 합니다.
Work clothes must be worn when processing materials using rotary tools, as the scattering substances may cause damage to the competitor. In particular, stepping on sharp and pointed foreign substances that fall on the floor can cause injury, so safety shoes must be worn before starting the work. When using cotton gloves while working with a rotary tool, the gloves may get sucked into the rotating part, so dedicated gloves must be worn. When testing energized equipment, it is necessary to wear insulation gloves in case of electric shock. Use caution when working since an electric shock can occur not only due to the contact of the hands, but also the arms. When testing high voltage power, wear insulation gloves and check the tester's mode accurately before proceeding with the work. Check again the key points of the task we've worked on in the
다음으로는 이제 1차 시 내용은 이제 안전 공구와 이제 대략적인 공구 사용법 이런 거에 대한 내용이었고요. 이제 1차 시는 이제 마무리하고 2차 시 영상 한번 살펴보도록 하겠습니다.
So now, our first video clip is about the safety management and how to use the tools. So now we finalized the first video clip contents, and then we are going to move to the next video clip, the second one.
Hi everyone. This time we will learn about how to draw wire.
자, 2차 시는 이제 이 도면을 이제 제도를 하는 방법이랑 트렁킹 이제 설치에 대한 내용인데, 지금 영상에 나와 있는 이 도면은 저희 이 도면에 나와 있는 영상에 있는 도면은 저희가 이제 2017년도 카잔 아니 2017년도 아부다비 도면을 약간 간단하게 수정해서 진행을 했습니다.
So the second video clip is about how to draw the piping diagram and the installation of the trunking. And then we utilized the piping diagram for this video clip, which was used in the Abu Dhabi competition in 2017. We just made a little modification in the diagram.
Airways and modified ducts. Can read and interpret the given layout drawings, draw wireways and modify ducts according to the layout drawings.
Let us have a look at the key points of this task. First, after layout analysis, draw an accurate baseline on the work board.
Second, when drawing on walls, specific reference lines, datum center lines of equipment and trunking must be considered. Third, measure ducts accurately before any modification.
자, 이렇게 첫 번째에서 저희가 이제 요 베이스라인이라는 말이 나왔는데, 요거는 이제 기준 채점을 할때 치수에 대한 채점을 할수 있게 기준을 정하는 선을 의미합니다.
So in the first sentence, we mentioned about the baseline. This baseline means the reference line for the marking, especially the measurement marking.
지금 이제 도면을 같이 보시게 되면은 이제 요 가운데에 있는 요 베이스 라인을 말하는 겁니다. 가이드라인.
Let's have a look at the diagram together. According to this diagram, you can see the 3, 4 baselines.
그래서 이 기준선이 이제 치수 채점을 할 때 요 기준에서 이렇게 채점을 진행할 수 있게 선수는 작업 시작 전에 이 선을 무조건 그려줘야 합니다.
So all the competitor must draw the baseline for the reference of the measurement marking.
Fourth, when modifying ducts, use proper tools and check the cut edges and attachment points. Please double check preparations in detail and tools to be ready for the task. Let us have a look at the precautions to perform the task in this training. First, analyze the layout and check for significant points when drawing on walls. If you start drawing on walls right away, you might make a mistake, so make sure you analyze the layout and check for anything significant or important before you start drawing on walls. When analyzing the layout, highlight any important or significant points which need to be emphasized. Second, when drawing the baseline, zero point, make sure it is balanced in all directions. Measure the right-left balance of walls with a tape measure. If you set the baseline too high or too low, this might make it difficult to fix equipment on walls afterward. So be sure to measure properly when drawing the baseline. Drawing the baseline is a critical step since it influences where all the trunking of other equipment are to be fixed on walls. Third, when cutting ducts, check whether the cutting direction corresponds with the layout. Place the duct cover to face the bottom. Make the duct base to face downwards. This method is used frequently because the side of the duct cover is flat. When cutting ducts with the hand miter saw, there are many cases of misjudging the cutting direction, so pay extra attention to it. After cutting ducts with the hand miter saw, there will be two cut sections for each duct. These sections should be marked with numbers since they will all be used afterward. Fourth, when cutting ducts, hold the duct with clamps so that it doesn't wobble during the cutting process. Hold the duct with clamps. When doing this, control pressure that's applied onto the duct to prevent deformation. If the clamps hold ducts in the wrong way, the saw might get stuck during the cutting process and the cutting angle cannot be set properly. So make sure the duct is held in the right direction. Using a hand miter saw, cut the duct. When doing this, hold the duct with one hand to make sure it does not move when cutting. Fifth, before attaching the ducts onto the walls, drill holes for attachment. If you try to attach the ducts onto the walls right away without drilling holes for attachment, there will be no alignment among the walls, ducts, and bottom surface. So make sure to drill holes for attachment. Have a look at what we are going to do in this training.
So, 이제 요 제도하는 방법에 대해서랑 이제 덕트 이제 트렁킹 각도 이제 재단하는 방법에 대한 설명들이 나올 겁니다.
So from this point, the video clip is going to show you how to draw the piping diagram and how to cut the trunking according to the right angles.
일단 먼저 영상을 만들 때 이제 한국 팀이 이제 사용하는 기술들을 많이 영상에 담고 싶었는데 이제 영상에는 분명히 안 들어가 있는 부분도 있을 수가 있습니다.
Actually, when we made this video clip, we were trying to do our best to put as much as Korean own techniques to show you.
혹시나 이제 이 영상들 앞으로의 영상들이나 다음 차식 때 했던 이제 영상들에 대해서도 이제 다른 방법들이나 궁금한 부분이나 이제 포함되지 않는 부분들에 대해서는 언제든지 질문해 주시면은 고맙겠습니다.
But there must be some missing points regarding to our technique or the method. So please feel free to ask any suggestion or the questions regarding to our skills or technique or the specific method.
Analyze the given layout drawings and check for significant points. Analyze the layout drawings and check the quantity and names of equipment. Draw a hypothetical baseline with a highlighter on the layout. Calculate the measurement of control box and equipment, etc., according to the layout. When doing this, highlight significant points.
Now, you can see the Korean players using the method in the video. 분명히 이렇게 체크하는 부분들이 오히려 도움이 될 수도 있고 또 이런 방법들이 맞지 않는 선수들도 분명히 있을 겁니다.
Actually, this video clips are based on the Korean competitors' own skills and techniques, such as highlighting the important part. So this can be helpful for some of the competitors, or some, the other competitor might feel uncomfortable. Of checking this point.
이제 이 전기 제어 직종이 이제 처음 참가하거나 이제 약간 이제 방법에 대해서 이제 알아가고 있는 선수들은 이런 방법들을 한 번씩은 따라 해보시고 이게 좋은 방법이면은 본인이 적용해서 이제 기술을 좀 더 연마하시면 될 것 같습니다.
So I recommend that the beginner for these skills can follow, watch, follow, and practice this technique. And then they can figure out if it is a fit for his own skills or not.
The baselines on the three walls and the ceiling should all be connected. Draw wire ways and where control boxes and equipment are to be fixed on walls according to the layout. Mark bending points of conduits on walls. When cutting ducts, use proper tools and smooth out the sides where they are cut or to be attached. Set up a miter saw on the workbench with the proper cutting angle. Install hand miter saw to cut the duct. Place the duct on the hand miter saw. Mark the cutting point on the duct according to the measurement shown on the layout. And miter saw, making sure it doesn't move. after setting the angle and direction of the cut accurately according to the layout. Cut the duct. And drill screw holes for fixation. Remove debris on the cut edges using a Cerakut. According to the number marked while analyzing the layout. After the attachment, mark where the holes for conduits should be drilled on the ducts. This should be done according to the layout. Finalize where the holes should be located. Be careful to prevent the hole from getting bigger. Remove debris on the attached ducts. Clean out the surroundings.
2차시 영상은 이렇게 마치고요. 다음에 이제 3차시 영상을 살펴보도록 하겠습니다.
Now I just finalized the second video clip contents over here and let's move to the next video clip number 3.
Builders will modify and install cable trays according to the drawings. 도면에 따라 작업하는 것입니다. Let us have a look at the key points of this task. First, plan working order according to the drawings before starting. Decide on which task to be carried out first in reference to the cable tray installation layout. If the cable tray is expected to hinder the work process afterward, then do the later on process first. Second, mark the locations where the brackets will be attached on the wall. Third, install only the minimum amount of brackets required to fix the cable tray. Fourth, when cutting the cable tray, figure out how the cable tray will be bent first. Please double-check preparations in detail and personal protective equipment to be ready for the task. let us have a look at the precautions to perform the task in this training. First, when cutting the cable tray, confirm the location to be cut. When analyzing the drawings, check how the cable tray will be bent. This is because the location to be cut varies on how it will be bent. Emphasize things that are important or particular on the drawings with a highlighter. Second, check the direction of the cable tray to be attached. Refer to the picture and figure out whether the cable tray will be attached vertically or horizontally and how the tray will be bent. Third, when attaching the cable tray at the top part, decide on whether the ceiling should be made first. If the cable tray, located close to the ceiling, is fixed before working on the cable, workers might work under a narrow space, making the operation difficult. If the cable tray needs to be fixed on the similar position of where the other apparatus will be fixed on the wall, and its location is... Have a look at what we are going to do in this training.
So this video clip is about how to cut or install the cable tray.
일단 방법들은 뭐 다양한 방법들이 있겠지만 이제 먼저 메쉬 트레이 같은 경우는 한번 이제 잘못 자르게 되면은 이제 치수에 맞게 작업을 할 수 없는 상황이 생길 수도 있습니다.
There are several methods or techniques to cut or install the cable tray. But in case of the mesh tray, if the competitor performed the task with the wrong dimension or the size, they cannot perform the other task properly in the later procedure.
그래서 이제 자르기 전에 이제 정확한 치수로만 파악을 하시고 이제 정확히 잘라야 되는 부분에 이제 체크를 해서 실수하지 않게 하는 것이 제일 중요합니다.
So this is very important to take a measurement with the correct dimension and size, and then please make sure to mark the points in advance to prevent or lessen the competitor's mistake.
Let us learn about how to modify and bend cable trays. Look at the drawings and figure out how the cable tray brackets are to be attached. Count how many cable tray brackets are to be attached vertically, horizontally. The types of brackets to be installed vary depending on how the cable trays will be attached. So workers... We will mark the locations of where the brackets are to be attached. Count how many cable tray brackets are to be attached and check where they will be attached. Check the location and the number of brackets that will be drawn on the wall. For example, if the cable tray will be attached horizontally in 500 mm length, use 2T brackets. If there will be other apparatus installed at the location of where the brackets will be installed, mark the location of it so that they don't interfere with each other. If the brackets installed are worried to hinder the operation later on, mark them on the drawings. If you expect the operator later on to be hindered, mark the part on the drawings or the wall. If the bracket on the wall, install brackets at the marks penciled onto the wall. Side. Calculating the size of a cable tray accordingly. The cable tray, noise and debris from the cutting occur when using a jigsaw, so workers must wear protective gears. Prepare a cable tray and a jigsaw. While placing the cable tray on the ground, cut with a jigsaw. When using a jigsaw, the edge of the cut surface can be sharp, so conduct operation while standing close to the...
자, 지금은 이제 카잔대회 때는 이제 직소를 이제 선수들이 가지고 와서 작업을 할 수 있게 했었습니다.
In the last competition in Kazan, our team allowed the competitor to bring their own jigsaw tools to the competition.
이제 이전 대회 때는 이제 직소를 가지고 있는 선수가 있었고 가지고 있지 않은 선수가 있었는데 이제 전체 지급이 상하이 대회 때도 이제 지급이 안 된다고 하면은 뭐 톱으로 썬다 톱으로 절단을 한다든가 아니면은 니퍼 같은 걸로 절단을 해야 되는 작업이 생길 수도 있습니다.
So in the previous competition, some of the competitor brought the jigsaw with them, or the others cannot didn't bring their own jigsaw tools. So in the next competition in Shanghai, if the competitor wouldn't bring their jigsaw tool, they need to perform the specific task by utilizing the just a general saw or the nippers.
Side part of the cable tray. When cutting the cable tray, leave the outer flank of the bending part. Clean out the byproducts of the cut cable tray. For a safe working environment, when bending and fixing the cable tray, clean up the workspace after cutting. Tray in place. Place the bent cable tray onto the bracket and fix it with a down clamp. After adjusting the measurement, fix the down clamp tightly.
케이블 트레이 설치 같은 경우에는 이제 점수가 이제 저지먼트로 되어 있어 점수 항목이 생각보다 큽니다. 설치에 대한 점수가. 그래서 이제 한번 설치를 할 때 이제 흔들리지 않게 확실하게 고정해 놓고 다음 작업에 들어가는 게 좋습니다.
So in case of the installation of the cable tray, the marking for this task is performed by the judgment marking. So it has a very high ratio of the marking points and the whole marking point. So the competitor makes sure to fix the cable tray firmly in the first place and move to the next task. Now I'm going to finalize the number 3 video clip and then let's move to the next video clip, the last one, number 4.
This is according to the drawings. Let us have a look at the key points of this task. First, look at the drawings and mark measurements on the control panel using a mechanical pencil. Draw a baseline on the control box and mark the location with the mechanical pencil according to the measurement shown on the drawings. Mark the location of holes that will be punched out on the boxes. Second, when punching out holes, make sure you hold the battery drill vertically to the control panel. Third, after punching out holes, ream with a countersink and use a deburring tool for the part where the countersink cannot pass through. Fourth, after all holes are punched out, clean out the surroundings and install apparatus to the holes. Clean out the debris made from punching holes. Install apparatus to the hole according to the drawings. Label the names of apparatus according to the drawings. The apparatus on the labeling stickers and attach the stickers to the control panel. Please double-check preparations in detail and personal protective equipment to be ready for the task. Let us have a look at the precautions to perform the task in this training. First, check the hole sizes in the drawings before getting to work. Check the size of the connectors that will be fitted in each hole. Check the gap between the apparatus accurately before drawing. Second, when punching out holes, they should be done at the exact points where holes should be made. Place the center punch at the exact point where holes should be made and punch out the hole while holding the center punch vertically. If the center punch is slanted during the work, errors in hole size may occur when working with a hole saw. Third, when working on the control panel with a hole saw, hold the tool vertically. If the hole saw is slanted during the work, it can cause damage to the control panel or fail to make the desired size of the hole diameter. Punching out holes on the control panel. Since the control panel is made of steel, sharp debris is created after punching holes with a hole saw. Be sure to wear safety gloves and be careful not to get cut by the debris. Wear gloves when cleaning out plastic debris after using the hole saw. Have a look at what we are going to do in this training. Let us draw the control panel and boxes. Using a tape measure, mark the total length, width of the control panel, and draw with a T-square. Using a tape measure, mark the center point on the control panel. Using a T-square, extend the drawn line. Check the gap shown on the drawings, then mark on the control panel. Check the gap between the apparatus shown on the drawings, then mark on the control panel. Check the size of the connector that will be attached to the hole and mark on the drawings and the control panel. Competitors must check the size of the connector. Pilot lamp 25 millimeters, PVC connector 25 millimeters, etc. Let us conduct punching work with a center punch. Conduct punching work on the locations of the holes marked with a center punch. When using the center punch vertically at the center of the hole, the center punch must be correctly located at the center of the hole. Competitors should use the center punch vertically for if not fully secured on the drill, a wrong-sized hole could be made and the hole saw could get separated from the drill during the operation. Punch out the holes with the hole saw at the desired point. Hold the tool vertically to the control panel during operation. The reason why the tool should be held vertically is because
여기서 이제 홀소 가공에 대해서 이제 영상 볼 때 계속 vertically라는 말이 자주 나오고 있습니다.
So regarding to the video clip contents about the hole saw uses, it mentions the vertical or vertically.
먼저 이 수직으로 뚫어야 된다는 이제 두 가지 이유가 첫 번째는 이제 도어 같은 제어하는 이제 램프랑 버튼들을 가공할 때 치수가 있기 때문에 그 치수가 벗어날 수 있기 때문에 수직으로 뚫으라는 게 있고요. 두 번째로는 이제 홀소 같은 경우는 여기까지 사선으로 들어가게 되면은 이제 드릴이 말리는 경우가 있어가지고 좀 위험한 경우가 있습니다.
So the reason why this video clip mentioned that it is important to use the hole saw tool with the vertical angles. So when the competitor use the hole saw, they need to install some kind of lamp in the control box. So it is for making the right dimensions according to the diagram. And then if the competitor lean the hole, so when using it, it can cause the safety gloves can be sucked into the tools.
If it is slanted, errors in hole size could occur. Let us conduct hole reaming. Fit the countersink to a battery drill. The countersink should be fully secured on the drill in order to ream the hole smoothly. Using the countersink, conduct reaming to where the hole is created with a hole saw. Conduct reaming on the hole created with a hole saw. While operating the drill, slightly push with the countersink downward in a vertical direction, and to prevent any safety-related accidents. Erase the markings on the control panel and boxes. Spray cleaning solution on a towel and erase the drawn markings thoroughly. Attach the apparatus and the name of the apparatus. 1. After checking the drawing, attach the apparatus. When attaching the apparatus, fix it after determining the location according to the wiring. Two, to attach the name of the apparatus, write the name of the apparatus on the name tag sticker. At this time, it is necessary to check the drawing. Check again the key points of the task we've worked on in this training.
지금 1에서 4차 시까지 영상을 다 살펴보았고요. 이제 혹시나 지금 줌에 들어오신 분이 스튼이 들어왔고.
So now we finalized today's first live streaming lecture by watching and checking the video clip from number 1 to 4. So now let's have a look at who's joining our Zoom.
혹시 지금 화면이 다 안 나오는데 혹시 화면 나오게 하실 수 있는 분이 있으신가요?
If you guys don't mind, is it okay to turn on your camera if you want to? I mean the person who joined in Zoom meeting.
Alexandra.
Sidney가 있고.
네.
Alexandra 있고. 유리에 일단 있어요.
혹시 시드니 자리에 없나요?
Sidney, hello. Are you there?
세팅하게 되세요.
혹시 말했어요? 네.
Sydney, if you don't mind, can you use your microphone to speak at least?
Hello.
Hello, Sydney.
Oh, nice to meet you.
Yeah.
I will try to speak in English, okay? But I speak Portuguese and try to speak in English a little bit, okay?
Okay. 아, 네네. 일단 지금 영상을 만들었는데 혹시 이거가 도움이 많이 되고 있는지 한번 물어봐주세요.
I wonder that we already made a video course for giving a lecture for this skill. So I wonder that it is really helpful for the competitor or the experts or not.
For me, at the moment, the video is very good, is very clean to understand. For me, it's okay.
지금 혹시 이거 본 것, 이제 영상을 지금 본 내용 중에 혹시 뭐 이제 질문이나 아니면 이제 더 필요한 내용이 혹시 있는지.
So you watch this live streaming and the video clip as well today. So is there any questions regarding to the video clip or is there anything else you, any opinion you'd like to add?
Okay, if I understand your question, no, I don't have a question until the moment. Because the video for me is very good and very easy to understand.
네네네. 지금 혹시나 이제 보고 있으니까 물어보는데 나중에 지금 저희가 이 차시가 있는데 지금 앞으로 이제 세 번을 더 해야 돼요. 근데 했을 때 그때 어떤 이제 영상도 같이 보겠지만. 여기서 같이 공개적으로 해볼 수 있는 게 어떤 게 도움이 될 수 있는지 뭐 프로그래밍을 같이 해본다든가 뭐 그런 방법들이 있을 건데 혹시 의견 줄 수 있으면
Actually, we have three more live streaming sessions in the future. And then, except for the video clip, what we already made, is there anything else you would like to see? Through this live streaming lecture, or is there any opinion such as the adding some information or the maybe focus on the programming part like that? Do you have any good idea regarding to this?
Okay, one moment, please. 아이 트라이드 투 라이트 인 트랜슬레이터 to speak English because I have a little bit difficult.
Okay.
But I try, okay?
Mm-hmm. 네. 네, 돼요.
오케이. So far I find it's very interesting. A lot of technical information was presented on the video. But I don't have doubts until the moment. Can you understand me? No?
이해해주세요.
네, 이해했냐고 지금 확인하는 건데 네. 지금까지는 질문 없고 지금 좀 트랜슬레이션 조금 기다리고 있는 상태라고 하는데
네, 그러면 저희가 여기다 써주는 게 나을까요? 채팅에?
네, 그것도 괜찮은 것 같아요. 이거 제가 조금 쓸까요?
네. 이제 앞으로 그 뭐지? 동영상도 할 거지만 저 뭐 소프트웨어를 같이 해보는 거는 어떠냐? 어떨 것 같냐?
About dealing with the programming part such as software for during the upcoming lecture session?
One minute, please. For me, no problem, okay? Go to the program, yes? I agree?
네, 동의한다고 괜찮다고 하시네요.
일단 이거 지금 라이브 방송의 그 포커스가 어떻게 보면은 이제
You prefer start with Logo program or Kinex program?
아, 로고 쓸 거냐, Kinex 쓸 거냐. 일단 뭐 이제 방송이다 보니까 뭐 이제 처음부터 프로그램을 짠다기보다는 뭔가 이제 핵심적인 내용들, 뭐 이제 어려워하는 기능들, 뭐 KNX랑 로고랑 뭐 통신하는 거, 인터워킹 관련된 것들 그런 거를 공개하는 것도 괜찮지 않겠냐.
This is online-based lecturing, so it is hard to give a lecturing about the KNX program in detail. So maybe what about we can talking about a few difficult functions of the programming, such as the interlocking between the KNX and Logo, like that.
Okay.
괜찮다.
네네네. 그리고 혹시 저 유리엘은 어디지? 아, 뭐.
I also can see the name, username, Uriel. Uriel, are you there? 대화문도 끝났으니까 다음 자신 설명하고 종료해도 되겠죠. So actually, I think we can wrap up the Q&A session over here a little bit, and then maybe it would be better to give you the brief introduction about next live streaming session.
일단 뭐 시드니 뭐 들어와줘서 일단 고맙다고.
And then I really appreciate for seeing this. For seeing Sydney in this Zoom meeting and then live streaming broadcasting here. Thank you so much for that.
Okay.
그리고 다음에 이제 요거를 볼게요.
So now let's have a look at the PPT files.
자 이제 2차 시에는 이제 계획은 이제 PVC 전선관이랑 이제 알루미늄 전선관. 이제 그다음에 제어한 배선 관련돼서 이제 진행을 할 예정입니다.
So the second live streaming contents will be about the PVC conduit and aluminum conduit and the flexible conduit. And we are also going to deal with the panel, the control panel things and the wiring.
자, 그러면은 이렇게 2차실을 이제 2차실은 다음에 이제 2주 뒤에 이제 또 방송을 할 예정입니다. 혹시나 이제 또 들어오실 분들 더 많이 들어와 주셨으면 좋겠습니다.
So our next live streaming broadcasting, the second one, will be on in 2 weeks. So I hope I can see more people on the Zoom and the YouTube and the, our next live streaming sessions.
자, 그러면은 이제 종료하면서 이제 마지막 서머리 정리된 거를 한번 보도록 하겠습니다.
Now for finalizing today's lecture, let's have a look at the summary for today's lecture.
Sydney 질문 올라왔는데 이제 2차 시는 저희가 이제 2주 뒤에 9월 3일에 진행할 예정입니다.
So Sydney, I saw your question about the schedule of our second session. So it's gonna be 3rd September. I will type it for you as well.
그리고 시간은 동일합니다. 지금 약간 늦을 수도 그쵸? 이제 시즌 같은 경우는 좀 늦은 시간일 수도 있는데 일단 뭐 들어줘서 고맙습니다.
So I really appreciate it for seeing you on the Zoom and in our live stream broadcasting. I know the Brazil might be quite late time over there. So the next sessions will be on the 3rd. Of September at the exactly the same time as the first session. Yes. Actually, the diagram, all the diagram what we used on the video clip is based on the last competition's test project, but we made a little modification to simplify this diagram.
일단 그 질문대로 지금 저희 영상에서는 이 작업판이 이제 한 면으로 돼 있어요, 지금은.
So in the video clip, the words for the for performing the task has only one side.
근데 이제 요 17년도 아부다비 도면이랑 19년도 도면을 보면은 현재 지금 이 천정면도 있고요. 이제 총 이렇게 세 개의 면으로 이루어져 있는 게 맞습니다.
But according to the existing test project, what we use in the Abu Dhabi and Kazan competition, it has the three sides of walls and the ceiling walls as well. So you are right, Uriel.
카잔대 도면도 똑같이 이렇게 진행을 했었고요.
This is the piping diagram what we use in the Kazan competition, so it has the same type of wall. So it has the three side of the wall and the ceiling.
지금 유리엘이 이제 영상이랑 약간 혼돈이 있을 수 있는데 지금 요 월드스케일 사이트에 들어가면 이제 상하이대용으로 테크니컬 디스커션이 지금 올라와 있어요.
I think it can cause a little confusion regarding to the type of walls because of our lecturing video clip. But according to the test technical description for the Shanghai competition and the WorldScale website, you can see the same diagram and then the types of wall.
지금 이 직종정의 내에 보면은 요 여기 패널 레이아웃이 있습니다. 요 패널 레이아웃 보시면은 지금 레프트핸드 패널, 그다음에 센터, 라이트, 그리고 일루미네이션 이렇게 네 개의 판으로 구성되어 있는 게 맞습니다.
So you can refer to the technical description for the Shanghai competition, and then especially in the panel layout section, you can see the three side of walls, such as the left hand and central panel and the right hand panel, including the ceiling.
혹시 유리엘
Uriel, is that
답변이 됐는지?
enough answer for your questions, I wonder?
I would like a little information to Hijay. It's possible?
I'm really sorry, can you just repeat one more time for me?
소리 더못 올리네. 안 들려가지고.
Sydney, can you just leave your comments or questions on the chat for me as well?
Yes, I have a little comment. Hey Jay,
Yes.
I would like to congratulate the work very well developed and explained clear and direct way. I'm looking forward to see the next videos. I remember you and your competitor did a very good work in Kazan. My congratulations and a big hug from your friend from Brazil, and see you on the next date.
나중에 또뭐이 영상에 담지 못한 내용들이나 그런 거 있으면은 언제든지 메일이나 메신저 연락 주달라고 좀 얘기해 주세요.
So Sydney, so please give me a little favor. Like if you have or find out any missing point for our lecture or the video clip, feel free to tell me your opinions through our messenger or the email at any time. We are really happy to
Okay.
have that.
Thanks for your attention.
혹시 근데 유리엘이 답변이 아 온 건가요? Thanks 이게?
아니요. 안돼. Thanks 안돼.
답변 온 거죠. 혹시 이제 유리엘이랑 슈드니는 이제 뭐 더 이상 이제 질문은 딱 이제 없는 건지.
So for the last check, Uriel and Sydney, both of you guys have no further questions, right?
No, at the moment, no more questions.
Okay.
어떤 거죠?
Uriel은
네. 일단 그러면은 아까 이제 답변이 이제 설명에서 땡스라고 와가지고 일단 그렇게 종료를 하겠습니다. 일단 1차시 먼저 들어와 주셔서 감사하고요. 앞으로 이제 2, 3, 4차시 남았는데 그때도 한번 같이 진행해 주셨으면 좋겠습니다.
So I think it's our answer to Yuri's question was quite enough, I guess. And then now we are going to wrap up our first live streaming session and then same Zoom code.
어, 주대리님 이거 혹시 Zoom 코드가 다음에도 똑같은 거예요, 혹시? 아, 다 똑같아요?
Yes, Sydney. We are going to use the same Zoom code and the link in the next meeting, next live streaming session as well. Yeah, so now we are going to wrap up our first live streaming broadcasting, and thank you for joining our first lecture on the YouTube Live, and then I hope we can see the more people on our next three lecturing sessions on the YouTube Live. Thank you.